This one crucial element makes all the difference at the elite level, and the focus of training it to 100% perfection is too often lost at the upper echelons. I'll tell you four reasons why it's crucial. At the beginner levels and any human playing a ball sport, it's quite common and understandable to keep your eyes on the ball. Seems simple. Your coordination is matched with the object that the sport revolves around, the ball. The main objective for us goalies is to exactly prevent that one object from being inside the cage. So when a shot is released, I need to track that ball with my vision as best as I can. Not to track it only when it's shot from the shooter's hand and do the rest with my body. Not to track it only halfway and then feel that's sufficient. Not to track it 90% and since you feel the ball, relax. I mean, your vision is locked onto the ball until you have two hands with full control on the surface of the water and then checking your surroundings. I just played USA Masters Nationals 20s and up earlier this summer, and it's the strongest skill that I can attribute to playing well. We won and I got MVP. The 2023 World Championships just happened in Japan some weeks ago. I'm sure many can remember a goal here or there that happened to squeeze in. There's four areas that I can quickly give as examples for why you need to fully track the ball and turn your head. One, getting full control of the block. Shooters are obviously trying to shoot the ball into the cage. So whether it's velocity, different types of shots, trying to catch us off our coordination, you might end up getting your hand on the ball, but the job's not done. The buoyancy of the ball as you come down might push the ball into the cage. An opponent might try to tip a loose ball if you don't have full control, or you're more prepared if they come at you to prevent a ball under and a penalty shot. Not that it won't ever happen, but it really helps when you're laser locked in on that ball control. And of course, you're way more prepared to pick the ball up if you need to make a pass. The second is for full extension. You can get more reach on your one-handed lunges. As long as you turn your head the proper way with your chin and the rest of your lunge doing it correctly, not going backwards and properly on your angle, you can get a couple extra centimeters out of your reach. The third is you get every small percentage chance closer to a better block. Some athletes have told me there's coaches that say do not look at the ball in your full lunges, claiming you'll get there faster. I already said how you get a couple more centimeters reach in those lunges, but if you do not turn your head and track the ball, you won't be able to fully coordinate that blocking hand and that arm on the ball. Once you do turn your head and track the ball, you'll be able to make a better block. Maybe the goal becomes a tip out block. Maybe that tip out becomes a controlled block. When you get elevated and the shot is being released at 50 miles an hour at the 6 meter line, you need to at least track the ball. And you're doing that as much and as quickly and as fast as you can. It might not be 100% to be able to track that object, but my effort to track and turn my head will be 100%. Which brings us to the fourth point. Even if you are late and the ball goes in, the more you track and turn your head and train this with intention, eventually your reactions, your body will catch up. Your coordination is following your vision. I'm using this video mostly to talk about the priority of doing this, turning your head and tracking the ball. But in the future, I'll be referencing this a lot, as well as how to do it properly in most every skill. Quick note to end on, avoid tipping your ear down. You can do this with me and look around. This is far more disorienting. So like, follow, subscribe, and share. If you're a coach, feel free to direct message any questions you might have.